What is up, everybody? This is Billy Vandergaw, and today I'm going to show you how to get a Plants vs. Zombies achievement. It's one of the hardest achievements that you can get, and it is called Alive and Planting. The requirements are is you got to survive 40 rounds, which is actually 40 flags. And to do this, you have to do it on Survival Endless, and you can only get Survival Endless by beating all the other survival games. Survival Endless means it continues on and on and on. So I'm going to start a new game here, and this is about 2 hours of gameplay, so I'm going to speed it up here so we can condense it into 8, so you can see my strategy and how I went through things. First thing I really like to do is I like to build up a lot of sunflowers so I can get a lot of sun, which will allow me to purchase all the powerful plants that I need to complete this. And you have to complete most of your plant setup real early, because you use all the specialty plants that you get throughout the game, like the Gloom Shroom, and the melon pult, and that gives you the winter melon as a specialty. They cost a lot of money as you go through. So as the levels increase, they even cost more and more and more for those specialty plants. They increase. Once you get to level 38, a gloom shroom will cost you 900 sun. So you want to make sure you get those set up at the beginning. You want to make sure that you also protect your plants with the pumpkins. Allows them to take more damage instead of just getting in so quickly. And the most important thing to do is to make sure that you have the umbrella leaves spread out around on your map in the areas where I'm putting them, so that way it repels any of the bungee or basketball throwing vehicle zombies, so that way your plants don't get damaged. You want to make sure that you put the fume shrooms and upgrade them to gloom shrooms in the back, so that way if any digger zombies come through, it'll kill those too. The most important strategy to this is when you use the gloom shrooms, they do an area of effect with their fumes, and no matter how many zombies are there, if they're in that area, they get hurt no matter what. So it hurts the ones in the front and the back, as long as they're in that range of the flower itself. One of the big things you need to understand, though, is because they are mushrooms, you have to use the coffee bean to awaken them, because they sleep during the day. The other important thing is to understand how my plants are spaced out. I put all the glooms in the center, in the water, so that way they hit the edges of the zombies walking in. And you'll see that there's two spaces there that are free. I only put spikes there to help slow down gargantuans and vehicles, so they have to stop to hit them. If you upgrade those spikes to the higher level, which do cost a lot more money because they're a specialty plant, what it does is they last longer. Because if you use the spike weed just by itself, if a gargantuan or vehicle hits it, they just die instantly. Then you have to plant a whole new one. But if you upgrade them to be, what's it called? The spike rock. They last 3 to 5 hits much longer. So, you see that I'm doing that now. And the reason that I allow those spaces there, and not put all these plants all the way up front, is that's about how far a gargantuan or a vehicle like the Zomboni can get before it just blows up from all the damage that it receives from the gloom shrooms from their area effect damage. But I make sure I put down spikes because they're very important, because as zombies continue on, the spikes hurt the zombies walking on top of them, but if you get the vehicles and gargantuans, it slows them down and allows your plants to do a lot more damage, especially when they come in huge waves of hordes and the later levels close to 40. One of the other things that's very important is you want to make sure that you put cattails in the center, so that way it shoots down any of the zombies that are using balloons. It's important to get those up right up real quick too. They're a specialty plant too, so you know you only have to plant 4 in the center. Some people only plant 2 and get away with it. But I like them because not only can they shoot the balloons down, they can shoot into any lane, and they can shoot backwards. So if you're having trouble with some diggers back behind you, they can zip around and hit them too. You'll notice that I've kind of like eliminated in the top left corner and the bottom left corner of the map my sunflowers there, and I put down some umbrella plants so that way no bungee zombies can come down and steal those plants in the back corners that are not covered. So that way, as well as the gloom shrooms are killing those digger zombies, as you can see right now. All you really need to do from here on is make sure that you maintain your plants in the front and in the back. Not worry about the ones in the center because they're protected as much as possible. You don't have to put an umbrella plant up in the front because if the bungee zombie comes down and tries to steal a plant in the water, it'll die because of all the damage it's receiving from the gloom shrooms instantly before it can grab anything. You just want to protect the ones in the back that can't do a lot of damage quickly. You'll also see that I also have the melon pults, and I've changed them to winter melons so that way they slow down the advancement. And they do area effect damage too. So when they land, any zombie around in two lanes will get slowed down and hurt. So now it's just a matter of attrition. As you can see, I'm running out of sunflowers trying to fight a lot of these guys. And what you just want to do is you just want to make sure that you at least get to 40 flags. It's very important that you get to 40 flags because if you can't and you die, you will not get the achievement. Whole idea is you're supposed to get at least 40 or more before you die. So if you miss that chance, you obviously won't get the achievement. But as you can see here, I'm getting very close, and here's like one of the last waves that I have to deal with before it's 40. And a gargantuan throws a zombie past me in the lower part, and my lawnmower goes off and kills everything in the row. But that is one of the last flag rounds that I have to deal with. And here we go. And now I've completed 40. So everything's pretty much fine. As you see, I'm checking and it doesn't pop. Don't turn off the Xbox if it doesn't pop. You have to die. So here's round 41. And you'll see that I just won't make it. A bungee zombie gets past. And it pops. And that's all you have to do. And this is probably the best way to get the achievement. And just the achievement, not really to play more than 42 rounds. Anyways, we'll just verify that I got the achievement here. And if you like this video, please hit like and favorite it, share it. You know, it helps me out a lot, lets people know that I do these things, and it's great advice. Anyways, thanks for watching, and you have yourself a great day.